Hello everyone, this is Papa from StreetFighterTrainingSystem.com. I want to keep this final episode very short and show you what is my favorite Shoryu punish. Okay, so I have an Excel open over here and I put what I consider as the very best playbook situation that you will ever get. Okay, so it's with no surprise that you will see that the best Shoryu punish that I take are the ones that follow the foundation course. That means I want people, okay, to take the trade that follows the trend, that bounce out of the EMA, and so on, right? Always the same story with a good candle and whatsoever. So if we zoom on this trade, for example, so here there was a two move to the upside. So it's a Shoryu trade. Okay, so people might have short over here, but the problem of this, so if I try to zoom again a little, so the problem of this, right, okay, so am I able, maybe not too much to zoom, is that, that if you see here, they would have short and they would have had, first, they were not respecting the trend, right? So what I'm waiting for is for people to short over here, be punished, right, and take the opposing direction. And on this trade, I have the trend with me, right? I have the good candle with me. I have the EMA with me, right? So this is the very best setup. And I also draw the Fibonacci 61.8. It retraced to the 61.8, right? So this is a perfect Shoryu punish because it has all the elements that are on the foundation course. So this is on the long side, and I have another example on the short side. So I would have an impulse move. This would be the retrace. And then guess what? Some people, they would have tried to go long over here, right? Because they would have seen the down, up, down. Okay, but little did they know that this is not a good thing to do. Why? Because you have the 50 SMA above the 21 EMA. The candle is a shit, right? It's a doji, and I don't even know what is this candle. It's not even bouncing on the EMA. It's not above the EMA. So many mistakes that the people are doing, right? So those are the very best trades that you can take. Using the Shoryu punish, meaning you need to have like down, up, down, up. You put a buy, you do the reverse of what the beginners are doing. On the upside, it's up, down, up, down, and you do the reverse of what people are doing, right? You are searching for them to look at, are they taking Shoryu trades wrongly, right? On the wrong situation, and you will do the reverse, okay? So this is pretty much what I wanted to show you on this lesson. Very short. I want to have some final words to say that I hope that you like those lessons that we put together with Dean, and that it will be useful on your trading path, right? Don't hesitate to let us feedback on your success and also on your fail on the comment section. I also want to share that all the setups that I have given you during those three lessons, so three parts, part one, part two, part three, are not all the trades that I'm taking, right? But the reason is very simple, is my trading style is far more advanced than what I'm showing to you. But on this lesson, I really gave you what are the most solid setups that I take and that will also help you to win on the market. Once, of course, you are comfortable with all those basics and all those lessons that is inside your brain and you know what's happening, you can, of course, trade your own trading style and find your own setup. And on that time, you can knock on my door and come to challenge me, right? So that's pretty much it. So I'll finish with all those moves coming from Street Fighter, and I will probably see you on the market.
Okay.